In the previous video, we have seen that in MPLS network, there are many control plane options, including LDP, RSVPT, and segment routing. Where it happens that we use multiple control plane protocols on an MPLS network. One of its uses is LDP to segment routing migration process that I discussed in the previous section. During the migration process from LDP to segment routing, it happens that both LDP and segment routing are active in all routers in network within a certain period of time. In this video, we will discuss the inter-networking between LDP and segment routing, another application of using multiple control plane protocol in an MPLS network. By interworking, I mean that some routers support both LDP and segment routing, but others may only support LDP or segment routing. Interworking is how LDP and segment routing work together to route traffic from source to destination. In order to understand LDP and segment routing interworking, I've already prepared a topology to show you in a few steps how interworking works. In this topology, routers XRV1 and XRV6 are our edge routers. The address of loopback interfaces ranges from 111 to 6666 according to the router numbers. The subnet of the links between routers also depends on the router number. For example, 10.1.2 is selected for the subnet between router 1 and router 2. The last digit of IP address is also the router number. In step 0, it is supposed that LDP and segment routing are enabled in all routers. LDP is enabled with two commands, MPLS LDP in global mode and MPLS LDP autoconfig in OSPF or ISOS context mode. The segment routing is activated with two commands in OSPF context mode, segment routing MPLS and segment routing forwarding MPLS, and also the configuration of prefix SID for the loopback interface. In XRV1, segment routing is preferred with command segment routing SR-prefer in OSPF context mode. That means we prefer our traffic be forwarded with segment routing labels. If we trace from XRV1 to XRV6, it is expected that traffic will be forwarded with segment routing label over the entire pass, as it is preferred in the edge routers and LDP and segment routing protocol are activated in all routers. Let's check the configuration and also the traffic from XRV1 to XRV6. Show running config router OSPF. MPLS is LDP is activated, segment routing is activated, and segment routing is preferred. Trace from 111 to 6666. As you can see, the traffic is forwarded with label 16006, which is segment routing label. In step 1, we disable segment routing in XRV4. If we trace from XRV1 to XRV6, we expect the traffic in XRV1 be forwarded still with segment routing label. But in XRV2, the router cannot forward the traffic with outgoing segment routing label because a router 4 does not support segment routing. Instead, router XRV2 swap the incoming segment routing label with outgoing LDP label. The LDP label that router XRV4 assigned for the destination 6666. To swap the label from segment routing to LDP, we don't have to configure anything and it is done automatically. Incoming traffic in XRV4 with LDP label is forwarded still with LDP label. Although XRV5 and XRV6 support segment routing, but the traffic will stay with labels in the same control plane protocol as much as possible. Since XRV5 and XRV6 both support LDP as well, and incoming traffic in XRV4 is LDP, the traffic stays in LDP over entire path to the destination. The traffic is forwarded from XRV1, the segment routing label. It is preferred to stay in segment routing label during the pass, but in XRV2, it has to change the label from segment routing to LDP because router XRV4 does not support segment routing. Incoming traffic with LDP label in XRV4 remains in LDP until the end of the pass, since all routers in the pass support LDP protocol. Before going to the next step, let's disable segment routing in XRV4 and trace from XRV1 to XRV6. No segment routing. MPLS, forwarding MPLS. And interface loopback 0, no prefix, SID and commit. Now if we trace from XRV1 to XRV6 again, as you can see, the label is swapped in XRV2 from LDP, from segment routing to LDP. To make sure that 24007 is LDP label, we can use show MPLS LDP binding in, for example, XRV2. Show MPLS LDP binding for the destination 6666. /32, as you can see, the label assigned for the 666 by XRV4 is 24007, or you can check it also in XRV4 for the destination 666. As you can see, local binding is 24007. So in XRV2, the label is swapped from segment routing to LDP label, which is assigned by XRV4 for the destination 6666. Also, with show MPLS forwarding, we can make sure that the swapping from segment routing to LDP label is done automatically and without any configuration. As you can see, in XRV2, show MPLS forwarding from 16006, which is segment routing label, to 24007. The next hub is router XRV4. To summarize this section, in a segment routing network, if some routers between the pass and not at the end of the pass does not support segment routing, traffic will be automatically switched from segment routing to LDP and you don't need any extra configuration. In step 2, we will re-enable segment routing in XRV4 and disable segment routing in XRV5 and XRV6, which are the end of the pass. In other words, this time we will disable segment routing at the end of the pass, not middle of the pass. If we trace from XRV1 to XRV6, although segment routing has higher priority in XRV1, but the traffic cannot be forwarded with segment routing label because destination does not support segment routing, and there is no segment routing label or prefix SID for the destination. So the traffic is forwarded with LDP label over the entire pass. Let's check it. Enable segment routing again in XRV4. Segment routing, MPLS, forwarding MPLS. Prefix SID, index 4 and commit. And let's disable segment routing in XRV5 and XRV6. No segment routing MPLS, no segment routing, no segment routing MPLS, forwarding MPLS, area 0, interface loopback 0, and no prefix SID. And also in XRV6. No segment routing MPLS, forwarding MPLS, no prefix SID on commit. So let's trace again from router 1 to router 6. As we can see, when the destination of the traffic does not support segment routing, traffic cannot be forwarded with segment routing label, and it is forwarded with the LDP label over entire pass. To resolve this problem, we can use mapping server, which is the next step. Mapping server is a router at control plane that assign prefix SID to the routers on behalf of the routers themselves, and then advertise them through OSPF or ISIS. Mapping server does not have to be in the path of data plane, but here we enable mapping server in XRV4, which is in the pass. When routers receive the labels announced by mapping servers, they replace these labels by default with the labels that were manually configured in the routers. However, this behavior can be overridden. In other words, the labels assigned by mapping server have higher priority than the labels which are assigned manually in the router themselves. So with these commands, we can enable mapping server in XRV4 and then advertise it through OSPF. When the destination does not support segment routing, actually mapping server is responsible for assigning and generating and advertising label for the destination throughout the network. So XRV1 will have the label of the segment routing for the destination. So there is no excuse not to forward traffic with segment routing label. Let's check it. This command, I enable segment mapping server in router 4. Show running config segment routing and router OSPF. Make sure that is advertised by OSPF with segment wrote in previous SID map advertise local. With the command segment routing prefix SID map receive disable, you can disable the default behavior of routers which replace manually configured label with mapping servers labels, but it is enabled by default. With show OSPF database, show OSPF database opaque area, for example for 666, you can ensure that the labels assigned by mapping server are advertised via OSPF. As you can see, advertising router is XRV4, which is mapping server for the destination 666, and index ID is also 6. Then you can trace the traffic from XRV1 to make sure that traffic is now routed with segment routing label in XRV1. The traffic with segment routing label is forwarded up to router XRV4, but XRV4 cannot forward the traffic with segment routing label since XRV5 and XRV6 does not support segment routing. So in XRV4, incoming segment routing label is swapped with outgoing LDP label. To this happen, we don't need any configuration and it is done automatically. Let's check it. As you can see, in router 4, the outgoing label is LDP label, but the incoming label is segment routing label. To make sure that the outgoing label in XRV4 is LDP label, this is an LDP label, which XRV5 assigned for the destination 666, you can check show MPLS LDP binding in router XRV4 or router in XRV5. Let's check it. Outgoing label in XRV4 is LDP label. So show MPLS LDP binding for the destination 666 and neighbor binding or XRV5 binding is 24,000 for, or in XRV4 also you can check show MPLS LDP binding. Local binding for the 666 should be 24,000. For also in XRV4, you can check forwarding MPLS forwarding table to make sure that the label is swapped automatically from 16,006 to 24,004. So it is how interworking between LDP and segment routing works.